It was 7 o'clock when they came for me. Cherie was putting the children to bed, and I was upstairs, signing another pile of my memoirs, little realising that a new and final chapter was about to begin.
Darling, say goodnight, children.
Good night, Daddy!
Good night, my little Chancellor.
Good night, you, my leader of the opposition.
Daddy, who is Saddam?
Saddam? Saddam is a very bad man who lives a long way from here. And one day...
Who's that at this time?
I don't know. I'll go and answer it.
Good evening, sir. Are you Tony Charles Linton Blair?
Yes.
I have a warrant for your arrest, sir. The charge is murder.
Oh, heck.
We'd like you to accompany us to Scotland Yard, Prime Minister, if that's fine with you.
Right. Well, I'll just go and get my hat and coat, if that's all right.
Go with him, Sergeant.
Oh, thank you. I'm a big fan of yours, Tony.
Here.
What are you talking about?
Look, it's no big deal, okay? But I've been charged with murder.
You gotta start raving mad!
Mommy, what's wrong?
Children, go back to bed! Tony, talk to me. What have you done?
I've served my country. That's what I've done.
Right, Sarge, break down the door.
Look, these are the keys to the Cabinet Office and Chequers. Tell Gordon to run the country and keep trusting the bankers.
Why do you keep locking this, for God's sake? We've got snipers on the roof and police everywhere.
I'm sorry, Tony. It's a health and safety precaution for the children.
Oh, fuck health and safety.
Don't be a fool, Blair.
Calling all cars. Murder suspect's name is Tony Blair.
What? Middle-aged, middle-class, 5'10", sandy grey hair.
In a few brief moments, my life had been turned upside down. I'd gone from hero to zero. Probably the first Labour Prime Minister ever to be on the run from the law. Crikey.
Will tell you the future. He predicted the abdication of the king and the death of the film star James Dean. Yes, madam, your question, please.
Will the Beatles still be number one in 50 years' time?
No, the Beatles will not exist, but Paul McCartney will marry a woman with one leg.
Okay, yes, my love, for you.
What do the letters WMD stand for?
The letters WMD stand for weapons of mass destruction. Next question, please.
Where are these weapons?
And are they being hidden in Iraq?
I don't know.
I thought you knew everything, Professor.
There are no weapons of mass destruction. It's all one big...
Wow. Thanks, Babs.
Here, have you got the filth after you? What have you been up to, you naughty boy?
Look, I didn't do it, okay? You know? At least not in the way that they thought I did. And let's be clear on this, Babs.
Oh, blimey, what did you do that for?
Saw it in a film. Works every time.
Oh, shit. I'd better go. Thanks, Babs. Missing you already. It felt like the whole world was against me. Apart from Barbara Windsor, of course. I had to hide, but where?
Hey, is that Melvin Bragg? It's Tony Blair. I'm just outside your house. Yes, I gave you a life peerage from... Hello? Hello? Lord Bragg?
Peter. Peter Mandelson was the one person who never let me down. The architect of New Labour. He was the one man who'd kept the faith and agreed with everything I said. Peter. Peter, you there? Peter, it's Tony. You've got to let me in. Look, please, Peter.
It's urgent. I'm being hounded by the police. Help me. Peter!
What, you? Get your hands up. Who are you?
I'm Peter Mandelson.
Yeah, well, I'm Inspector Hutton, Scotland Yard. I think it's time you and I had a little chat.
I stayed hidden for hours that night, behind the Ritz Hotel, watching the immigrant workers below me, toiling away in the heat and steam of the kitchens. They couldn't know that just yards away was the very man who had secured them a minimum wage of £5.60 an hour. Although I love you so, walking the streets that night, I thought of all the people who had supported me in the past, like when it came to Afghanistan.
Tony, I've got the Kremlin on the line.
Oh, hi, is that President Putin?
Yeah.
Hi, it's Tony Blair. Yes, listen, you don't have a problem if we invade Afghanistan, do you? Sorry, did you get that?
Putting you on speakerphone, Tony. My volunteer would like to hear your question again.
Oh, no problem. Hi, guys. Listen, you don't mind if we invade Afghanistan, do you?
You know, as I lay on a bench in Kensington Gardens that night, I thought of all the good things that God had told me to do, and that all the sacrifices others had made were somehow worth it. But hey, in the end, only God and history can judge me.
Mandelson, 456140. Get your shoelaces back on and come with me.
Everything you want to know.
Right then. Let's go back to the beginning. Let's go back to the night that John Smith died.
Ah, well, I can certainly tell you all about that. They were all there that night at the Savoy. Gordon, Tony, Alistair, Robin Cook.
Together,
souls are on. So I would like to propose a toast to the new leader of the next Labour government, John Smith.
John Smith.
John Smith.
Thank you, Robin, for such kind words. As you can probably imagine...
Look, Peter, if John dies, I will be leader, not Gordon. And I think somehow this will happen.
What do you mean, if John dies?
Look, don't cross me over this. This is mine. I know it, and I will take it. How we can forge new destiny
for socialism. Blair actually said that.
Oh, yes. It's all in his book. Page 63, chapter 2.
Oh, I see. Go on.
Then, just after dinner, John Smith left the room to make a phone call.
For a great social problem, we need people like you.
Of course, I just kept saying to Tony, John's a great leader. That's all I kept saying over and over again.
Oh, hey, Gordy. What's up?
You said we had a deal. If John should die, it's me who becomes leader, not you.
Well, hey, watch this space.
Moments later, the Labour leader was dead. And soon after that, Blair was on his way to Downing Street.
So sad.
And he doubled the swing this century, the biggest Labour majority in its history. But the party elected today was his creation, forged as a way of making Labour electable after 8 years.
Can somebody help me? Oh, the washing machine's broken.
I'll take a look at it. Oh, hi, dear. Here's my list of celebrities for our first media at home party. Duran Duran, Peter Stringfellow, Cilla Black, Jim Davidson, Ronnie Corbett, obviously, and Michael Caine.
What? Darling, they're all Tories.
Well, you know, there's no point in inviting a load of socialists. I mean, how many people have heard of Billy Bragg?
Tony, I'll take care of the guest list.
Oh, great, thank you, sorry. Things are going really well. After a cold, wet night on that park bench, I thought it was time to get out of town. Ha, if only it was that easy. Being such hot news, this was one story I couldn't spin. It was all looking pretty hopeless. But I still had one or two cards up my sleeve. Hi, is that Bernie Eccleston? It's Tony Blair. You couldn't lend me a really fast car, could you? Preferably one without Durex written on the side. Hello, Bernie? Hello? Bernie?
White House.
Oh, hello. Can I speak to George, please? It's Tony. It's urgent.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bush is on a call. Can you hold?
Yeah. As I stood on that drafty station, I remembered that fateful night in Washington when I met George. I won't mince words. It was life-changing.
Tony, call for you.
Hello?
Tony Blair?
Who is this, please?
There's a car waiting outside for you. Be out there in 10 seconds.
What's going on? Where are you taking me?
Don't worry, Tony. Everything's going to work out fine. Mr. Bush wants to see you for a little tete-a-tete.
Should have got the right George Bush, the one with the cowboy boots.
Just sit back and relax, Tony.
You do know who I am, do you?
Yeah, sure. You're that singer.
I'm,
I'm the Tony Blair, I'm the British Prime Minister.
You're a funny guy, Tony. I hear you guys drink a lot of tea. What is it with that? You can't get no coffee over there?
No, I can drink both.
Okay, I'm good with that.
Tony, my good friend. So nice of you to make it here. So, you met my friend Donnie Rumsfeld?
Yeah. Hi, everybody. So, everything all right, George? It's a bit unexpected.
Hey, come sit down. Relax. Give him a drink, fellas. Can I get you a cigar, Tony?
Not just now. I don't smoke much. Well, social occasions.
Just smoke it, you prick.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, I like you, Tony. You're a nice guy. And I'm gonna get straight to the crutch of the matter here. Let me tell you something, Tony. I'm gonna fuck Iraq. Make no mistake, my friend. I'm gonna fuck him big time. And I want you to be there to fuck him with me.
Yeah, well, shoulder to shoulder. I've gotta stop.
No, that was a crusade, Tony. This is a whole new war. Different thing someplace else, you understand?
No, you know, I'm really up for this war. But, you know, maybe it'd be good if we could think of, you know, a reason why we want to fuck Iraq.
I could whack your fucking limey gay ass, you prick. How's that for a reason?
Yeah, don't make me look the bad guy, Tony, right? You got yourself a nice family, you got a nice business. Don't cross me on this one, okay? Now we pray.
Tony, Robin Cook's here.
What the hell is going on? We're already at war with the Taliban, and you want to make an unprovoked attack against Iraq? Well, what are you, insane?
No, that's not a war. That's a crusade. I mean, this is a proper war, with tanks and everything.
What? Tony, yesterday, 2 million people demonstrated in London against this war. Well, what are you going to say to them?
I don't know. How about fuck 'em?
You war crazy bastard! You can't do this! It's illegal! Parliament won't let you! The Cabinet won't let you! And neither will I!
Bye, Cookie. Lovely to see you.
Tony, I've got Silvio Berlusconi for you.
Hi, Burley. You're up for this war, aren't you?
Ciao, Antonio. You want a war?
No, war. And look, even if you're not up for it, just say you are, okay?
Don't worry, Tony. You keep our mouths shut. Except for you, Noel.
Right. Thanks, dude. Catch you in Tuscany. Okay, that's one, two, three.
I'm sorry, Mr. Bush is still on his call.
Yeah, will you tell George I need a plane or an aircraft carrier to get me out of here?
Okay, I'll pass the message on.
Thank you.
There he is. There's Blair.
Is that legal?
Oh, sorry, bit of a tight spot there. And I saw it once in a film.
I know who you are. It's Tony Blair. I voted for you, Tony. I'll never forget that night. Things can only get better.
Thank you, but, you know, I'm travelling incognito, so...
Oh, wait, Tony, let's hang the bankers from the lamppost. Let's get them workers out on strike.
If you read my book, you'll know I'm not really a socialist. So can we talk about something else, like to keep racing idiots?
Eh? No, and I didn't keep whippets neither, you patronising bastard. See that? Das Kapital, Karl Marx, that's a book. not 700 pages of your delusional...
Oh, just my luck. A drunken left-wing dinosaur. He probably got Clause 4 tattooed on his back.
The Brooklyn Stonewall Party! Tony Blair! Tory Blair, more like, yeah? Tory Blair! Tony Blair!
Shut up, OK? Just shut your drunken left-wing mouth!
Sorry, sisters, but these tickets aren't valid for this train. Not on a Friday.
Tony Blair!
Shut up, OK? Just shut your mouth!
Come on, the worker! Long live the revolution!
Of course it's sad when someone gives up their life to a cause, however misguided. But in the end, the decision I made to kill him was, I think, the right one. I jumped the train outside Trowbridge, a late Labour win in 92 when I was a promising MP and rising star. They were happy days indeed. Now, here I was alone in Bristol, probably the most misunderstood man in the world.
I was moving in here today. No, in fact.
Not yet, sir. Not while you still suffer from psychological problems and Tony Blair's still in charge. Good day, sir.
Don't call me a psycho! Now let the fish off, you bastard!
Oh. When will I ever be rid of this man?
5 years ago, Cherie and I bought a flat just above here, but stupidly I'd lost the keys. And this was where I kept my first love when I was a student, Ava. Oh, heck, Carol Kaplan. Just what I didn't need back in my life.
I was wondering whether you'd show up here. Just the car you want, is it?
Well, to be honest, I didn't know you were here. I thought Cherie had had you evicted.
Oh, she did, but I changed the locks.
Well, that shows spirit.
You're looking pretty fit, Tony. What have you been up to?
Well, you know, I still play tennis 3 times a week, and, yeah, your workouts helped.
But are you keeping a straight back? And breathing? Deeply? Using your diaphragm like I showed you? So I hear you wrote a book. Do I feature?
Just a small mensch. It's more about what I did, why I did it, and why I was right to do it.
Humble as ever. Coffee?
I just have a high-protein drink, actually, then I'll be on my way.
Well, I've got a tin of carnation milk. Best I can do, I'm afraid. So, where are you going to go?
I don't know. I just crashed a friend's pad.
What friends, Tony? You don't have any.
Yeah. I guess I'm a bit of a loner. I remember that night we won the election. As I climbed the steps to the podium, I knew that I was alone. There would be no more friendly team. No more shared emotions among a band of intimates. There would be them, and there would be me. Chapter 1, page 11. It's a direct quote from my book. Oh, Christ, someone's called the police.
Oh, yeah. I did what I heard you breaking in downstairs.
Oh, shit.
How many more of these damn books are we going to get? Bush's, Tony Blair's, yours?
Who am I supposed to believe, anyway?
Oh, I think you'll find my book, The Third Man, is the best value at $24.99.
Is that so, Squealer? What's that famous quote again? A tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing.
Oh, Shakespeare, sir. Macbeth, Act 5, Scene 5. Now, apparently Redgrave was voted best Macbeth.
Oh, I rather like Peter O'Toole's version.
Shut up, both of you. Right, Hans Blix and his men are scouring Iraq to try and find Saddam Hussein's weapons of mass destruction, and they found nothing. What was Blair's reaction?
Look, we need a reason to go to war. What's the reason? Come on. I'm really up for this war. Have I got to think of everything myself?
I think I have an idea.
Tony, John Scarlett from MI6 is here to see you.
Oh, come in, John. Did you get my message about finding some weapons of mass destruction somewhere? Like Iraq?
Yes, Prime Minister, but so far we've drawn a blank.
Oh, come on. I mean, have you looked in the palaces and under the beds and in the cupboards?
Yes, sir. And as you'll see in my report, there's nothing there.
You know, you're really getting off message here. Can you not say there might be some there just to get me off the hook?
HarperCollins on the phone for you, Tony.
OK. What fucking prick wrote this dossier?
He did, Alistair. Sort him out, will you?
You? Come with me, you. You overpaid fucking waste of space. What the fuck is this about? When you wipe your arse in the morning...
Hi. Yeah, it's about my book deal. 800,000 words by Christmas. Sure, no props.
Fucking shit. Now, you go out and find them and don't come back until you do find them. Now, fuck off.
And I'm huge in America. I mean, I...
Tony, the washing machine's broken again. It just goes straight to rinse.
Look, Cherie, I'm not a plumber, I'm a Prime Minister.
Well, that's a pathetic excuse.
Is it? Why?
Is it?
Oh, for fuck's sake, Cherie, put a sock in here, will you? Leave the poor fucker alone.
Oh, shut up, you little man.
What are you smirking at?
I think I've found an Iraqi missile site.
Looks like a brewery to me.
Okay. How does that look now?
A top secret brewery. Perfect. I'll send that to Colin Powell.
And the rest goes to charity.
Sounds like a win-win to me.
Tony, what are we going to do about Robin Cook? He's threatening to resign.
Look, I'll take care of Robin. I'll take him for a friendly walk in the Highlands. Mind how you go, Cookie. These rocks are very slippery.
Oh, another one of your lies, I expect.
Oh, come on, cheer up, will you?
You expect me to be cheerful with you dragging us into another war?
Look, we're going in, OK? Get over it.
You know, I really want to punch you in the face. I've been wanting to do this since Clause 4.
Calm down, Cookie.
Stop calling me Cookie, you little bastard.
Oh, thank you. Robin, come back! That was the worst moment of my life, seeing my best friend Robin lying there, dead. But there would be time to weep later. Luckily for me, the Bristol police went to the wrong address, and I got overstarted and hit the road. Once again, I was a lonely fugitive on the run.
The hunt for Tony Blair continues with an unconfirmed report that he's been seen driving a blue Ford Anglia. Police are advising everyone not to approach the ex-Prime Minister, as he could be armed and a danger to the public.
Oh, don't be so hysterical. Bloody media. What do they mean, danger to the public? Oh, shit, I killed again. Yet again, another unavoidable death. But hey, shit happens. Suddenly, I was on a road that was strangely familiar. I knew I'd been here before. Right.
Right here was the one person in the world I didn't want to call on for help, but I had no choice.
Sorry, sir. Blair's killed again, this time on the A4.
Oh, dear God. Surround the area. Shoot on sight.
Mrs. Thatcher.
The Cecil? Cecil Parkinson?
No, it's Tony. Tony Blair.
Oh, the pretty Tony Blair. Come here, where I can see you. Come to Mummy. Are you in a lot of trouble, Tony?
Well, you know, I might have made a few honest mistakes, but, hey, I think I can talk my way out of it.
It was always that blind faith in yourself that made you so very appealing.
Oh, thank you.
Very much like myself. We're a unique brand, you and I, Tony. Three terms each as Prime Minister. I won my war, of course. You didn't, did you?
Well, mine's actually a bigger war. You know, more tanks, more rockets, but it's looking good. God, I think I used to fantasize about her. Yeah, we had quite a lot of flag wavers too, actually. Well, it was time to split and leave this fading diva with her shaven monkey.
They still love me, you know. They still need me. Those little people out there in the dark. Which is why the mummy must return! Clear up the mess that the children have made while I was gone.
You know, it was sad to see her so bonkers, but handy for me in the circumstances. At least she wouldn't turn me in.
Excuse me, sir. Madam would like you to join her for dinner.
And Tibbet, find him something nice to wear. Not this shabby salesman look.
The last sighting of Blair is around here, sir. But then suddenly he disappears. Just here.
All right, Mangelson. If you were Blair, where would you be?
Tuscany, Florida, or Barbados with Cliff Richard.
He's not on holiday. He's on the run. Where would he be?
Oh, yes. Yes, of course.
Of course what?
General Pinochet hid out here when he, too, was on the run for mass murder.
Where, damn it?
Have you forgotten the Iron Lady, Inspector?
Were you smiling at Squealer? Things going your way, are they?
I don't know what you're talking about, Inspector.
I think you know exactly what I'm talking about, Squealer. You thought you could control Blair. You thought you could contain him. And then when you got left out in the cold, you just couldn't stand it, could you? And we all know what happened to him, don't we, Squealer? You changed sides.
Thank you. All right. How are we going about this? What's in it for you?
Seat in the House of Lords. Decent pension for me and Carlos.
All right.
I think Lady Thatcher would like to see you in something like this, sir.
And whatever you do, do not open that cupboard. There.
Okay, I admit it. I'm drinking too much. But hey, I'm only human, and that's what people really like about me.
Dennis.
Where'd you get all day?
Dreaming, I'm always dreaming, dreaming, love will be mine, searching, I'm always searching.
Come on!
Hoping, someday I'll find...
Everything all right, Mr. Brown?
Hey, who's that?
Someone, your driver, sir.
A bloody gun to work, Phil. Keeps missing. It's all Mandy's fault. I mean, look.
Here, sir. Let me try.
Keep right on dreaming. Till my dreaming comes true.
Yeah, sort of wish we hadn't banned fox hunting now. It's a pretty cool look. You know, I wondered what The Guardian would say if they could see me toffed up like this. Hey, better not go there.
What kept you?
Maggie, I...
You look good. Come here, Hunt Master. Did you know it was my birthday?
No, sorry, I should have known.
Kiss me.
What?
Kiss me.
The thought of kissing all that lipstick made me want to turn myself in.
We've got him cornered, sir.
Good. Be very gentle with Lady Thatcher. Don't forget, she's very frail.
Oh, you were incredible, Tony. You devoured me like an animal.
Yeah, you know, I love women. I had a lot of them in the cabinet.
I don't do women. I do war. Now, where were we?
Oh, thank God, it was the police.
Tony!
Tony! No, gentlemen, no one has been here. And the Baroness will not receive anyone tonight.
I'm sorry, sir, but we have a warrant to search the house.
Here I was, back in the city. Anonymous. Apart from my sackcloth toga.
Hey! Get back here!
Blair's been spotted in the West End, sir. Apparently he's dressed as Julius Caesar. Bit of a lightweight for that part, I would have thought.
Enough of the Shakespeare. Squealer, you better come with me. I might need a snake charmer.
Gordon, I have some rather interesting news for you.
To the end of a lollipop.
I knew that I couldn't run around dressed like this all night. But where to go? The theatre. Of course. Everyone's dressed like an idiot in there. When you come
to the end of the yeah, good show tonight.
Oh, my God, it's you. I knew this would happen. I knew you'd turn up here. You killed all those people.
Well, you know, not all of them.
Murderer! I expect you're going to kill me next. Help me, somebody! Murderer! You're probably going to strangle me with my own tie. Good idea.
Obviously, one doesn't enjoy throttling light entertainment performers, even if their material is weak. But, regrettably, in life, one has to make choices. Then, decision made. You simply move on.
Professor Predictor, the man who escaped from Assassin's Bullet and predicted the winner of this year's Grand National.
Okay, where are you going? We better go on.
What?
Scout in here somewhere. I can smell him, I swear.
Sarge?
Yes, ma'am. Next question, please.
Will Tony Blair ever be brought to justice?
Well, clearly, Tony Blair will take his place in history as one of the great world leaders of our time. I'm sure if he were here today, he would proudly say he'd do it all again. And I'm only sorry, he's only sorry, that he didn't invade more countries, like Iran and Pakistan and Turkey and...
Where's the bloody exit, then?
That's a dead end, sir.
Oh, God, I hate that theatre.
Oh, you obviously never saw Trevor Nunn's Coriolanus.
Will Gordon Brown ever be elected Prime Minister?
No, absolutely not. Gordon is clearly emotionally unhinged. And if I were him, I'd get out of politics and, sign up to an anger management course.
Red-faced bastard. The boy's head off. I hope.
Professor Predictor, are you able to predict your own death?
Look, you know, it's whatever God decides. I thought I was doing really well till some idiot took a pot shot at me. Oh, shit. Oh, hey, Gordon, how's things?
You double-crossing bastard!
Typical Gordon, always in a strop. Obviously something had upset him. You'll love it. The girls, the parties. Power's a great aphrodisiac.
I'd rather see you dead! Gordon, put the gun down. Ah, fuck!
What's happened, Inspector?
Blair's been shot in the arse.
God. Terrible way to go.
He'd been washed up in Deptford. Terrible.
Well, I guess this is it. And it's not all bad news. The thing is, I know if I can get to heaven, once there, I reckon I can talk my way in. And if I keep talking to the right people long enough, who knows? With a bit of luck and things go my way, I could end up a saint. Saint Tony. Wicked, eh? What am I?